1989 Red X Bash. Over 1,000 crazy people, and there are even crazier machines, are set to roll from the east coast of Australia to the west coast.
Sweep. It's still got its thing on.
Along with my mate and manager, Glenn Wheatley, I'm driving a superbly prepared Peugeot 404 all the way to Broome in WA.
Well, I'm pretty confident, although I've never done anything like this before. I'm looking forward to it very much. I don't care if we don't win. The main reason that we're involved in this thing, right, Glenn, is because
for the kids,
obviously it's
going
to raise money for the Variety Club to help children. We're going to have a lot of fun doing this.
The rain going to slow you up?
No way, Jose. But no, we're going to go 60, maybe 65 mile an hour all the way.
But we're also going to beat the wives, Gainer and Jill, who are also in this car behind us.
We're going to take the girls out. Oh, we don't care if we don't win the whole event. As long as we beat the girls, because we will never be the end.
Look at the wide angle, the wide shot, a soft tiger, soft tiger.
Glenn's wife, Gainer, and my wife, Gillian, are competing in an identical 1964 Peugeot. Graham McVean and his crew pilot the third vehicle, which makes up the Australian Television Network rally team. The girls, well, they've been gearing up for this for months now and reckon they'll teach us all something about dirt track rallying.
They have got no hope. They have no sense of direction. They can't drive nuts.
All I want to say is that the idea of this thing is simply to have fun, not take it too seriously, and raise as much money as possible.
This is a rally, but it's a rally with a difference. There are two main aims. First, to raise big money for the underprivileged and handicapped kids of Australia. And second, to have a whole lot of fun. They've come from all over Australia, the United States and England to be part of the bash. And even Margaret Thatcher's daughter, Carol, will take on the Australian bush. Past the Blue Mountains, the weather finally cleared. We were heading for Bourke, where, the next day, the Bourke to Broome Red X bash would officially start. When we arrived, the whole township of Bourke seemed to be on the streets to welcome the rally for the fifth year in succession. Ahead of us was to be many thousands of kilometres of dirt, dust, mud and water, which would take us through the great Australian outback and those strange landscapes of Aboriginal legend. But in the rough and tumble of the Red X rally, nothing could save the girls from a treacherous hairpin bend, nor us from wrongful arrest in the lawless West. On every other morning, the wide streets of Bourke are peaceful. But on this morning, some very strange people prowl.
Good morning, fellas.
Good morning.
It's a worry.
There are mechanics who just shouldn't be working on electrics.
Turn it on again. Oh.
Maybe you should have been a plumber.
Turn it off.
And there are nurses, who aren't really nurses at all. But just as the start warms up, disaster strikes.
No cameras.
Wheatley and I have been arrested. No charges are laid, but in the back of our minds, there's a faint suspicion that the girls might just have had something to do with it.
Me and you, oh, what? Sailor. I'm in deep trouble now. Don't put me in with a sailor.
As bail is negotiated with the local constabulary, the fire brigade generously wash a few vehicles. It's a parting gift our English friends had not exactly expected, but in the true English spirit, they made the best of it. Things were starting to look pretty good in the lock-up, but a bribe was accepted in the name of charity, and the great race was underway. But first, let's check the route of our Cross Australia journey. From Bourke, we travel to Dirranbandi in Roma. From there, it's a long hike north to the Isa, and then, bashing through rough bush tracks and old stock routes, we'll cross the Northern Territory in the Kimberleys before finishing in Broome on Australia's west coast. When a hurricane is blowing, there's nothing you can say. In the outback, there's still plenty of water lying around from unseasonal floods. And the locals warn of dangerous dips filled with water. Some take the road cautiously, while others just take it as it comes. The track to Dirranbandi gives us all our first feel of the dirt, but there are other surprises too. The floodwaters are running quickly and deeply, and there's only one sure way to cross. Three or four vehicles are hitched together and then towed by four-wheel drive. Arriba
Dirty Roma. Glenn, we told you not to sing.
They thought it was you. I love it.
Chileans up to her old tricks again. Maybe it's something to do with the monotony of the endless open plains. But even these vast spaces in Australia's outback have stories to tell and secrets to keep. It was from here, Roma, that the famous Australian explorer Ludwig Leichhardt plunged into the wilderness in 1848. His daring plan was to be the first to cross the entire continent of Australia from the east coast to the west coast. He and his party were never seen or heard from again, while strange rumours of wild white men living with Aborigines persisted for years. From the day that we were born, we've been heading down a track. Sometimes it's made for good, sometimes for bad. But if we look behind us, there's a way coming down. At last we come to the checkpoint for the first control section of the rally. We'll not only be racing the girls and the rest of the field, but also the clock.
I'll give you a kiss.
Kiss him, call him all now.
Deadly serious now.
I'll turn the group, please, man.
Yeah, we're going through the mud, aren't we?
You're going through the mud, you're turning right.
The girls going through the mud?
The girls are going
That's
through
where
the
we're
mud.
Going.
You're following the girls, are you?
No, they'll be following us in moments.
Oh, will they?
Yeah.
When we started the rally section on the way to Blackall, the home of the legendary Black Stump in Queensland, we didn't know just how eventful the day would be.
What's that 3777? It's real lumpy.
Gillian Gaynor started in the lead and, with a little encouragement from Vinny, their personal rally advisor, drove superbly.
Bit of a ditch, just take it easy. Drive through it, don't slow down too much. That's it. Go on, keep it going.
Here we go.
Straight ahead. That's it now. Keep it in second, get away in the third. Second and third, you come out, give it a bit more. A bit more, and charge. Charge, keep it going, let go, don't finish.
But in rallying, it takes just a momentary lapse of concentration to surrender the lead.
Baby, through your love,
across. I've gone for it. I've got him. We did it. All right. All right. I love it.
Sorry, ladies, but all clear and all messed up.
Okay, I'm happy, man.
One mistake often leads to two when you push corners to make up lost time. Gillian pushed a corner like this one just a little too hard. And when the dust settled, she found her car on top of a log.
What we've got to try and do is put the car this way, casting light on it. Pull, that's it, go.
Oh, yeah.
Go. Go.
Go on.
But it was the girls who had the last laugh. We made a navigational error and they wasted no time in getting home first.
Hey, I can handle a humiliation. It's just done by women I can't handle.
After 5 hours of hard driving in the dust and dirt, the tiny western township of Orgathella looked, well, like paradise. But I got to tell you, the welcoming committee made the whole rugged journey worth the effort.
Hi, everybody. So you got a day off from work? You get a day off from school? Yep. Whose book have I got?
Sean's.
Yeah, Sean.
You sometimes forget when you're recording in the city that your music will stretch right across this vast land and make a real bond with Australians in the smallest and most distant of outback settlements.
If you sing me a song, I'll sing you a song. I know the words of that one.
The bond that music makes is truly a common one.
To deal with you.
So I'll sing Matilda, okay?
Okay.
One, two, three. One of the girls came and came by a billabong under the shade of the blue-eyed tree.
Oh, louder!
He sang and he watched and he waited till he stood up.
Oh!
Come for all the singers in the city.
Big chorus! Twinkle, twinkle. No, I'm only kidding. You know, you're the voice?
Yes.
Well, if I sing a bit of that, will you clap along?
Yes.
And sing the bit that goes, whoa! Will you do that bit for me?
Yes.
Okay, you ready?
Yes.
We have the chance to turn the pages over. You gotta clap your hands. We can write what we want to write. We gotta make ends meet before we get much older. Hey, girl. We're all someone's daughter. We're all someone's son. How long have we been each other?
It was back to the dirt and dust. We were heading for Longreach and then on to that remote billabong where once a jolly swagman camped. We thought a bit of hard driving had put some space between us and the girls, but they were right on our hammer.
Oh, the girls are just... Where did they come from? Where the goddamn hell did you girls come from?
Well, it happens to the best of them. That's racing champ, Dick Johnson, in the big caddy down there. He joined the rally in Blackall for the stretch to Mount Isa. But things just weren't going poor old Dickie's way.
What happened, Dick? Did you find another rock?
No,
mate. We stopped to help the say hello to the kids. And what happens? Starter motor.
She failed.
You can't win Bathurst and you can't even have a decent run in the back.
I had a starter motor stop me at Bathurst. And believe it, in the bash too. So we'll fix it.
As for us, we rolled on into Longreach and the magnificent Stockman's Hall of Fame. It's sort of like coming across the Sydney Opera House in the middle of the Australian outback. But while Glenn and I played tourists, the girls had their car washed and secretly hit the road.
Mate, there's a cafeteria here.
So they were well ahead of us again. We reckon we were out driving them, but seriously, the girls were outsmarting us by a country mile. Anyway, north of Witten, with the control section safely behind us, we could take time out to take in the landscape. Last we came to Combo Waterhole and Combo Station, where Banjo Patterson first heard the story about that ill-fated swaggy who camped here, stole a sheep for tucker, and waltzed into Australian folklore. A long time ago, Banjo Patterson wrote Waltzing Matilda here. Once a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree. I'm assuming that's a coolabah tree. I've never seen one before. This is the billabong. But it's really quite a strange feeling being here. I mean, there's a lot of people around at the moment because most of the rally cars stopped to have a look, but God, goosebumps, it's great. Once a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. Come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you come a waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You come a
Kimberley moon is shining on me, as soft and yellow on high in that indigo sky, smiling gently.
After all the dirt and dust of the past week, fistication of Mount Isa's Irish Club was a dream come true. The bashers were given a bash they'd never forget, this time by Channel 7. First, rising young country star James Blundell got the toes tapping.
The bugs grow, the barmaid mad, the drinkers all look hunted, and the pressure of the play was so great that the barman's growth was stunted. They've been cursed, that kicked, that trodden in the floorboards, hurled against the wall, been kicked, it thumped and shoveled out the doorway, doesn't bother them at all. There's thousands of the little baggers everywhere, each night their force grows stronger. Oh, well, they camp all day in the old pub's roofs, can't take it too much longer.
Then the long, lovely legs of Jackie Love got hearts thumping.
Hey,
As for me, I was just a happy spectator until my fellow drivers shamed me onto the stage.
If you clap hard enough, you reckon we can get Johnny Farnham? My daughter's idol. Come on, John, come and give us a song. Just one song. Just one song. Come on, everybody. Get up. Give him a hand. Australia's greatest singer. The man who led us into our bicentennial year. Ladies and gentlemen, John Farnham. Thank you.
But without the band, I really needed some help. I really enjoyed myself. It was like going to a party with 1,000 good mates. During the day, we'd be in the bush swapping jokes and yarns over the CB or helping each other out if we broke down.
And sing us the best, why don't we say, help me if you can, I'm broken down. 2, 3, 4. Help me if you can.
I'm broken down.
But at night, we were singing and dancing to raise some money for the kids. The black tie dinner at Mount Isa took more out of the bashers than the rally itself. But early the next morning, it was business as usual. As for us, well, we were firing on all cylinders because today, the master of Mount Panorama, Peter Brock, joins our team.
I'm here, mate.
Mark, oh, so glad. We need you. Where are your glasses? You've got to have the welding goggles.
I've got the goggles, mate.
Well, we'll have the goggles.
Yeah, yeah.
Now,
so, but what tricks are we up to?
Well, the girls have got all the tricks. We're just out driving.
Girls there. Cars there.
Cars looking good.
Yeah,
fantastic. No trouble whatsoever. I bent the rim on one of the back ones yesterday.
Right,
but it's okay.
Okay, look, so the main thing is team meeting later on, no TV cameras here.
Yeah, no, I'm into that.
Rules, regulations out the window,
yeah.
And we're going to win.
But absolutely, at all costs.
Right, right.
I'm in there, see you out there.
As Brocky got the feel for his purring Peugeot, we caught up with rally director John Flower.
How'd
you
go?
All right?
Yeah, actually, it's a good run.
Look.
6, 6.5.
2 hours, 25, 30. Mate, that is spot on. You've got a perfect time.
No finding?
Good section?
Oh, absolutely fantastic.
Good.
Yeah, it was a bit sloppy in the middle.
Yes, that's right.
But not too bad at all. Hey, listen, we must be about halfway now.
We are about halfway. Gannett Creek is in the middle of Australia, and then we go north from there to Newcastle Waters and on to Victoria River Crossing.
How many cars have we lost? Have we lost many?
Mate,
of the...
Despite having those 5 rollovers the day before yesterday,
yeah.
All those cars are continuing.
Fantastic.
And so we're still up with about 207 cars, so we're doing very well.
Yeah, I heard a rumour the other day that there's a possibility of the net being something like $2.5 million.
I think we'll pull in certainly over $2 million. Thanks to your effort last night at Mount Arkham, that was brilliant. I think we would have picked up about 25,000 to 30,000 just by you singing. There were people, let me tell you, who were prepared to pay more for you not to sing.
Yeah, well, that was one of them was Wheatley. Do I have to give you any money for any more extra points? Or you got any money, Wheat?
If you want to buy some more points just to have a better score.
Yeah, I think a better score.
Or indeed, if you want to make sure that the car behind you doesn't get a good score, we can organise that.
Right, well, I'm prepared to pay $100 to be 10 points in front of the girls.
$100, I'll take it off you now.
Well, sir, you give us $100.
Speak to the man.
You got a deal, okay.
Thank you,
make
sir.
It hard for him about that back there.
Yes, all right.
Keep the change, John.
All right, thanks, Johnny.
See you, mate.
Glenn, thank you.
And it was right here we discovered one of the secrets of our wives' success.
Okay, because they just put on $150 worth of points.
Right, well, we'll take...
But I'll take this...
I've got it.
They were quite determined that they want to lead, you know.
Yeah, I know. We're more determined.
There
we are.
That'll do. We'll call it quits at that. All right, that gives you a perfect time. It's two perfect scores for these two cars.
Well, how much to take off their perfect score?
Oh, should we say 50 and I can fiddle the computer a bit? Lovely, thank you. What a shame they didn't do as well as you did.
Yes.
Okay. So we decided to fight fire with fire and bring on the master himself.
Oh boy.
Clear road, boys, look at this. Now time for a quick lap. This is like an Adelaide Grand Prix, Ben. Right, this is it, qualifying. We're into it.
We were travelling well, but maybe we were becoming just a little too cocky. And when Cocky Brocky lost his hat waving to a chopper crew, Carol Thatcher's Humber still looks in pretty good nick, but others seem a little worse for wear. Most drivers will be pretty content just to get through this difficult section. But, as in all rallies, some will come to grief. As it turned out, the driver escaped with minor neck injuries. It's a sobering reminder, though, of just how dangerous rallying in the Outback can be. With Brock at the wheel, we were as safe as houses, and comfortably once more in the lead. But my navigating skills were just about to let us down.
What's our ref, mate?
Rat Fink. Rodent Leashes. Really fast.
RF stands for right fork, of course, but when I thought of it, it was too late to help Brocky. I've never heard such gibberish.
Yep, we're fine.
No, we're not.
And of course, he was right. We weren't fine.
I love it!
A few other cars made the same mistake, but the girls, with a little help from their friends, stayed on the straight and narrow. Disappeared into the dust ahead of us yet again, we had other things to worry about. As I said, what could possibly go wrong? We had lost both our clutch and ignition, and were eventually towed through the bull dust to the next checkpoint.
This thick, apart from what comes out of his mouth. But no, it's been serious.
Give me a cuddle, baby.
Just can't see it there. The dust real thick. But we need some serious clutch adjustment, right?
I need a bath.
You dirty mongrel.
I know.
Put your arms around me, baby.
This man will hold me tight. Come on.
Oh, you're filthy.
But with a new battery, a drop of clutch fluid...
Give me a kiss.
...and a dusty kiss...
Watch your back.
We were back on track. Ahead of us are the Kimberleys, the bone-jarring, axle-cracking stretch of the Gibb River Road, and the finish line. In the northern part of Western Australia, there's plenty to see.
Yellow on high in that indigo sky, smiling gently.
Like the magnificent Lake Argyle, nine times the size of Sydney Harbour.
Had that feeling.
And lining the road, huge boab trees. But it couldn't be put off any longer. It was time to get off the bitumen and onto the infamous Gibb River Road. This is a treacherous track which cuts across the northern part of Western Australia to Derby on the coast. The so-called road is 2 days' driving of waterways, corrugations, stony creek crossings and washaways. Apart from that, it's plain sailing, except for the dust. The dust and then the dust.
Indigo sky smiling gently.
Here's a sight you won't see every day on the Gibb River Road. That's the steroid sisters, and they look as if they could use a few steroids to get out of this mess. But instead, they just enjoyed getting everybody else bogged. It seems as if nothing can stop the old 1928 Model A Ford. Others just go across country and God help anyone in their way.
Come on, George.
On ya, George. At the end of the Gibb River Road, the rally swings south to the finish at Broome. But we've got a very special invitation to sit in class with some very special Aussie kids.
Well, what an amazing experience this is. It's absolutely fantastic. What Peter and I thought we would do is invite any questions. Jason, how long is it till I get back to my home? We get back home, I think, on the 3rd, and I'm looking forward to it very much because I have a son at home who's 7, and I have another little boy at home who is also my son, of course, who is 16 months old, and I miss them very, very much indeed. Over.
This is the Kimberley School of the Air in Derby. Here, young children isolated by distance can still go to school, not by bus, but by radio.
Oh, that's fine. Did I stop and hand them out, or were you one of the people that I sort of posted them to at high speed? Over.
He's got a sense of humour.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, we hope you got them, but we're in a bit of a hurry, running a little bit late, you see.
Only half an hour with the kids of the Outback was all too short. But we had Broome in our sights, and the girls were still in the lead.
Hey, Rocky, we're going to take this 10 kilometres to go. The girls are gone. We're going to try and take them.
get round. Come on.
This is it! This is it!
Yeah, this was it, Broome. And as promised, the girls had come in first. Their methods may have been a little unscrupulous, but their determination won them the Bash Trophy for most enthusiastic.
I think it's great. I had a great time. There's a lot of guys out there that didn't think we'd get here.
Or tried not to let us get here.
Exactly. Mm. But this is easy compared to childbirth, believe me.
Our Peugeots won the team prize, while Car 999 and E.H. Holden took out the overall award. But the big winners of this mad, mad, mad rally were the children of Australia.
OK, now turn your radios down, because it's going to be very loud. Over. Here it comes.
We have the chance to turn the pages on. We can write what we want to write. We got to make ends meet before we get much older.
Stay watching 7 for Crime Stoppers, 2 minutes of Queensland's Most Wanted. Then it's the return of action and adventure to 7.30 Saturday. MacGyver is back and raring to go after some tough fortune hunters next. Then the 50th anniversary screening of The Wizard of Oz, here on 7.